Someone's being hurt. Open this door, or I'll kick it in!
Don't mind her. She likes to watch. Ooh, look at you. Such authority. Such aggression. I can see why Pericles has taken such an interest in you. Did you come to join us?
It sounded like someone was in pain.
Well, it can sometimes be hard to distinguish between sounds of pleasure and pain. Had I known you were going to knock, I would have left my door wide, wide open for you.
I only came to this symposium to find someone.
Sounds like we can help each other then, doesn't it? You fetch us a bit of oil, I help you find who you're looking for. Maybe they're in here.
She's not in there.
I think I'll check all the same.
After your display earlier, it's probably safer I get the oil.
Obedient, too. I knew I liked you. Don't take too long. If you don't get the oil soon, all our fun will end.
Ιον τέστη προσκλεί την Κάρια μεταξύ του κεφάλου του πηχαίος. Πού τον διαμεστεί.
Amistios in Pericles' abode? I never thought I'd see the day. You must have seen me doing my impression of Hermippus. I call it
the dejected weasel.
Tell me, what does it think?
I am called many things. It isn't one of them.
What do you call yourself then? Creature of many names?
Alexios.
I wouldn't peg you as an Alexios. But never mind. I'm Aristophanes. And this man is Euripides. Oh, go on. Introduce yourself.
I'm Euripides.
For a playwright, you're not much for words.
Good men lead quiet lives, as old Euripides likes to say.
Don't you, Euripides?
Now, if you'll excuse us, I was just about to dazzle this old dog with my impression of Pericles. I call it the wooden board.
The man is your host.
Under every stone hides a politician, I always say. And Pericles is no different.
And so it isn't the rich and powerful, but the gods who are the source of justice.
What? No! Have you been listening to nothing I say?
I only use these terms, war, gods, civility, etc., in context of what we can observe. I can see soldiers fighting, sure. Does that really bring me any closer to understanding war?
Amistios? At this party? Well, at least you're someone new to talk to.
Sure, we can talk. What about?
Before Protagoras changed the subject, we were talking about the next great leader of Athens, Cleon.
I'll change the subject again.
I'm looking for someone. A Spartan woman.
Spartan? Hopefully she's dead in the gutters. It's better than those mongrels deserve. I wonder, if you found the woman, even if you saw her with your own eyes, would you believe her existence to be true?
This is getting nowhere. Forget it.
If you don't want to discuss that, then what?
If you're an ally of Cleon, why would Pericles invite you?
You're not from Athens, outsider. Here, we keep our enemies closest of all.
Why isn't Aspasia here?
Can you be certain she isn't? To observe her presence is still no guarantee that she is here. In my opinion, it's just like her to cower in the shadows while we stand out here in the light.
This has been useless, Chiere.
Του ξεχνευτά ή τι να πληροφορούσε, ποιο ζώο υπάρχει, ποια χειρόνα πλήρησή του εσύ.
Έναν εξάδελφο, γέρο.
Just can't stay away, can you? Did you bring the oil?
You've grown up in Pericles' home, and yet you're so different.
No one is like Pericles. And he's only slightly more serious than usual, too. Athens is under siege, and he worries for her future. Which is why tonight is a fine time to celebrate what may be our last taste of freedom.
When you walked in, you seemed like you and Socrates were...
How I wish you were right. One day, we will have that man in here with us. I promise you that.
I might be back.
If you come back with a jar of oil, I promise to show you how grateful I am.
Amistios? Here? I suppose they've sent you to mock me for my fight with Euripides.
Spare me. I'm only looking for clues to help me find a Spartan woman.
A Spartan woman in Athens. Sounds intriguing. Though, if you expect me to notice someone other than myself, you expect too much. You could talk to Euripides. He's the second most worldly man here. That pediculous, Xanthodontus exothalmic Morozov. But he doesn't talk without a drink.
I have no idea what that meant.
No, you don't.
So, we get him drunk, and he talks. He sounds more Argive than Athenian.
Impressive, foreigner. Euripides is from Argos.
All right. If nothing else, this party could use the help.
You'll need to pick the right wine for this task. The kitchen should have what you need. Let me know when Euripides is done in, and I'll slip away unseen.
How do you know Pericles?
I believe you mean to ask me, how does Pericles know you? I'm the greatest dramatist in the land, mentor to Euripides, lover of Asclepios, father of theater, and so on, and so on.
I'm sure it's a real honor to have you hiding in his kitchen. You're awfully worked up over Euripides. You sure you're just friends?
I'm never just anything, foreigner. Though I confess, Euripides and I hold a bond deeper than brotherhood. Why he slams it with a banal young plaything, Aristophanes, I will never know.
I'll get the wine.
Wonderful. Now, if you want some friendly advice, Aristophanes cannot stand sweet wine. I've seen what it can do to him. Absolutely, horrifyingly delightful.
It wouldn't be a party without someone losing their stomach. I'll let you know if your plan worked.
You shouldn't be in here. What do you want?
I'm here for your sweet wine.
Yes, take it. But get out of my kitchen. I'm very busy, you know.
Much to do, and many unknowns on our horizon.
It's come back for more! Care to see my impression of Protagoras? I call it the flapping bladder.
I'm sure he wouldn't.
When I need to relax, I start to fight. For you, though.
Quickly! Bring him some wine so that he might say something clever.
After my argument with Sophocles, I think I'd rather keep my head clear.
I'm only here because I'm searching for someone.
And yet it gave us the distinct impression it was here to fill our wine. Let's focus on that first, shall we?
You and Aristophanes could both use a drink. Let's play a game.
A competition?
Ah, wonderful idea. Everypides seems quiet, but he never turns down a challenge.
Well, if you brought us some wine, I wouldn't be opposed to showing this young one how we argives drink.
Why don't you just apologize to Sophocles?
It's he who should apologize to you.
Sophocles is a friend, and one good friend is worth an entire family. He just needs time to recover from his outburst.
Pericles has invited all of you here for some reason.
Either we dine here and praise Pericles, or we dine with Cleon. But Cleon has all the charm of a typical politician. A horrible voice, bad breathing, and vulgar manners.
Let's conjure Dionysos, shall we?
This is pure swill.
Amateur. In my day, this would be considered nectar of the gods. Another round!
Ready for more?
I can hardly stomach this pig's piss.
I could outdrink both of you with one hand. Let's have some more.
You ready for another?
This wine is terrible.
You, I like you. Who brought you here?
I brought myself. I'm on the trail of a woman who fled Sparta a long time ago.
Fled? Why?
She lost 2 children. She had no choice.
She fled to heal a broken heart.
Euripides, write her into a play.
I've heard Spartan mothers go to a sanctuary in Argolis to beg Asclepios for his divine pity. I should know, it's my home.
After what she went through, I'm not sure she would trust priests.
Then she sought my friend, Hippocrates. He's a physician, best of the best. He still keeps his office in Argos. If she went to him for help, there's no doubt he'd have given it.
I love getting drunk and singing. Come back if you want to sing with me.
I'll think about it. Hippocrates in Argos. Here I come.
Just can't stay away, can you? Did you bring the oil?
I come bearing gifts.
We're saved! Today, these women grieved for their sons, and these men worked the wall. But tonight, we forget all of that. Let's have some fun!
What do you say?
Care to join us?
Now it's time for you to help me, Ali. I'm looking for someone.
All business right until the end. I like that.
Focus. I'm looking for a woman who fled Sparta a long, long time ago.
Fled Sparta? No one flees Sparta. But let's pretend she did. If she were stupid, she'd be dead. If she were smart, she'd do what Aspasia did. She'd earn her independence. The smartest and most resourceful women I've ever met have been in Corinthia.
Pietera? I've heard they play some sort of role in Corinth, but I assumed it was the same as any other city.
Oh, no! These women are unlike any other you'll meet. A force, and the only ones there with any smarts.
Ali! Come back inside!
Ooh, the celebration continues. When you reach Corinth, find Anfusa. No one goes in or out of the city without her knowing. Until we meet again, warrior.
Anfusa in Corinth. It's not much, but it's a start.
How's Euripides? Drunk, I hope.
You can stop hiding here. Euripides won't notice you coming out. He won't notice anything.
Hiding? She did it. What has come at us? First they take our phones, then they take our heads. I ain't found out with my dignity intact. Or what's left anyway. If you see Euripides, tell him I say thank him for another colorful evening.
I'm surprised to see you here, but everything has a price, as you said. I can't help but wonder what price you paid to gain entry to the symposium.
Keep wondering.
You really intend to use this young destruction to avoid the point being argued?
If you've been arguing this long and you haven't agreed yet, just give up.
We're discussing the nature of your rules. We're better to do so than to hear. I'll ask you the same question I asked Thrasymachos. Would you agree that our ruling is an art?
It is an art, so we undertake it. That is not up for our argument.
Yet medicine is for the betterment of the patient, and not the physician.
carpentry into the building, not the building.
There is the art of ruling, not for the betterment of the ruled rather than the ruler.
Don't be absurd!
This argument between you two is pointless.
Perhaps.
How do you define art?
I'm not getting dragged into this.
Very well. Answer this.
Does the artist go before the little has a thought?
Well, yes.
Laws and justice do much sense for people, do they not? And is there any better way to communicate the story or a people than by revealing its customs and laws? If yes, then ruling and justice must be a stressing process.
If you say so.
Aspasia.
Socrates. He really has a brilliant mind. Even if he comes off a little strong.
He is always like that, is he?
Ah, Phoebe. Pericles has retired to the balcony already. His ability to sneak off and salt out is second to none.
I can do that, and Alexios can help. Everyone is listening to Tito.
That'll be fine. Run along. Alexios will be right behind you. Now, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Aspasia. I had to go to great lengths to cover up our work on Megaris.
Your spies have been watching me. I knew you people
will be trusted.
We do what we have to survive, and there's no shame in that, believe me.
You make an interesting choice, Alexios, in not dressing to fit in.
Fit in? Fancy clothes wouldn't help me fit in. Your Athenian chitons are strange to me.
You never really get used to them.
It seems we have the attention of the entire room without a single eye being fixed on us. If you'd like to talk, do it now and do it discreetly.
I've been searching for a woman named Mirini, my mother. I think she may be in danger, and my search brought me here.
What clues do you have to her whereabouts?
A physician named Hippocrates may have seen her in Argos.
He's a good man. If you find a woman named Agathe there, do let her know Aspasia sends her regards. What else?
Alcibiades gave me the name of a woman in Corinth.
I'm sure he did. My dear friend, Anthusa, is the only one I know who's enjoyed a life in Corinth through legitimate means. Mostly legitimate, anyway.
That's all I have.
There is another option. In a former life, when I needed something done or someone found, I contacted a friend. An admiral of a sort.
What's his name?
Her name is Xenia. When we last spoke, she was in chaos. A word of caution. When you go to her, be on your guard. Sea life makes a monster out of most people.
Thank you, Aspasia.
When you're done, return here. Together, we will find who you're looking for. Now do me a favor and get Pericles to come down here and greet his guests.
Alexios.
I don't recall sending for you, Miss Theos. Phoebe shouldn't have let you in here.
Phoebe did nothing wrong. Aspasia asked her to let me in.
Of course she did. I can't say I'm thrilled about going down and speaking to everyone. Technically, you're a guest. If you join Herodotus and me, that should be enough for her, don't you think?
You really don't want to go downstairs, do you?
When your days are spent speaking in front of crowds, you begin to crave these moments of silence. Or as silent as I let it be, at least.
Phidias was awaiting trial, but you had me get him out of Athens. I figured you, of all people, would want to follow the law.
Phidias is a very dear friend. I didn't want to risk him being found guilty. And, of course, there were other threats.
So you knew?
I know he's delusional, but one day when you have a friend you'd do anything for, you'll understand.
Why send Mitiochos to the fishing district if it's dangerous?
I would never have sent him into danger willingly.
It seems you have many loyal friends.
My people are important to me.
I don't understand why you had Anaxagoras ostracized. Socrates said he was your friend.
I won't risk the lives of those close to me if there's something I can do about it.
So you did this to protect him?
Anaxagoras understood my fears. 10 years may be a long time, but at least he'll be safe.
Your life is in danger.
Yes, yes, Herodotus was saying. This cult doesn't worry me. I have my life threatened by far worse people every day. My true concern is Athens. I fear for her future.
The Spartans aren't your real concern, Pericles. The cult is coming, and they're bringing their strongest weapon.
Listen to him, Pericles.
The Spartans are immediate. A cult's threat is ambiguous.
I'm related to one of the cult members. And I believe her when she says they're coming after you.
Sound counsel to consider. I'll be sure to let my men know, regardless.
Aspasia sent me to see what's taking you so long.
Tell Aspasia I'll be right there. I suppose this is where our conversation ends. Thank you again for helping me. I hope my guests are able to help you in your search.
Time will tell.
You look tired.
Only of conversation. I think that's the most talking I've ever done.
See?
You didn't need the weapon after all.
Are you leaving?
I've had enough Athenian hospitality to last me a lifetime.
You get used to it. It's nice. What are you going to do now?
There is a physician in Argolis that may be able to help me.
You're sick? You've never been sick.
No, I'm fine. I just need to talk to him.
Okay, good. It would be weird if you were sick.
Before you go, I heard something from Aspasia about Kefalonia.
What is it?
She said there was some sort of plague. You don't think... My friend, the blood fever.
Don't think like that. Whatever happened on Kefalonia isn't our fault. I'll go myself and find out if this plague even happened. Okay?
Okay. Thanks.
I knew I could count on you.
Not going to beg to come along this time?
Nope. I'm happy here. And this isn't Kefalonia. That means you'll be back.
That's very true.
Plus, I really like working for Aspasia. She says she has a mission for me.
I'll see you soon, Phoebe.
Bye, Alexios!
Right.